Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, you'll learn how to track button clicks into Google Analytics 4 using Google Tag Manager. By following these steps, you'll be able to track button clicks, like people clicking to add an item to their cart, clicking a button to make a booking, requesting a callback, or any other call to action button that you've added to your website. Okay, let's get started. We're going to track two buttons into Google Analytics 4. We're going to track a call to action button and an add to cart button. To do this, we'll need to configure a variable, a tag, and a trigger in Google Tag Manager. A Google Tag Manager variable lets us capture information from our website. We'll use a variable to access information about the button that someone has clicked. For example, we might want to track people clicking a button in a form. We can use a variable to access details about the form someone is using on our website and the particular button they clicked. We will also create a tag. A tag lets us send information to the different platforms we're using. We'll be creating a Google Analytics 4 event tag and then sending details about the button someone has clicked through to our Google Analytics reports. And you also have the option of creating other types of tags in Google Tag Manager. For example, if you want to send details about the button click to Universal Analytics instead of Google Analytics 4, to Google Ads or Facebook. And we will also create a trigger. A trigger lets us control when to fire our tag. We'll configure the trigger to look at the information available in the variable, and if the details match the button we want to track, then the trigger will fire our tag, which will then send an event to Google Analytics 4. If you're just getting started with Google Analytics 4 or Google Tag Manager, then I recommend taking a moment to download my Getting Started guides and checking out my other resources. I've included links in the description below this video. The first thing you need to do is find the button you want to track on your website. I'm going to configure Google Tag Manager to track two buttons. I'm going to track people clicking the button for my email newsletter, and I'm going to track people clicking an Add to Cart button for my store. Let's start with a button for my email newsletter. We can see the button on the page, so we're going to view the source code. I'm going to right-click the button, and I'm going to select Inspect. This opens Developer Tools, and we can see the button is highlighted in the source code. We can see the button, and we can see that it's located in a form, and that the button has a class of newsletter-form-button. This means we can use the class to track people clicking the button. Let's copy this so we can use it in Google Tag Manager later. Now let's look at another example. Let's navigate to my store. And let's select the product. We can see the Add to Cart button. Let's right-click this button and select Inspect. This button is created using a div, but we can see it also has a class of sqs-add-to-cart-button. Let's copy this, as we'll use this in a moment. So far, we've found the buttons on our website, and we've identified the classes we're going to use to configure our triggers in Google Tag Manager. In some cases, you might not find a class for the button you want to track, so you could also use the ID of the element instead. I will also show you another way to identify the buttons you want to track. This can be useful if you can't find a class or an ID. Now let's head to Google Tag Manager.
If you're stuck trying to figure out how to track particular actions using Google Tag Manager, like clicks on buttons and links, then you can use this method to find ways to use those actions to trigger particular tags.
First, we select Variables. And then we're going to click Configure for the built-in variables. Now we're going to enable all of the built-in variables under Clicks. If you want to track form actions, then you could also enable the built-in variables under Forms. Now we're going to select Triggers. And we're going to click New. Let's name our trigger All Clicks. And select Trigger Configuration. Now we're going to select All Elements.
and we can save our trigger. Now we need to use Tag Assistant to identify what we can use to track our buttons. So let's click Preview. We enter the URL of our website. And we click Connect. Our website loads along with Tag Assistant. Now we need to find the button we want to track. And let's click the button. Once we've completed the action we want to track, we can select the Tag Assistant tab. Let's select Click. And then Variables. This lets us view the information we can access in Google Tag Manager. We can see the value for click classes, the value for click element, the value for click ID, and the value for click text. We can also see that there are no values for click target or click URL, so we are not able to use those variables to trigger our tag. For this example, we'd need to use either click classes, click element, click ID, or click text. So if we didn't have a value for, say, click classes, then we could create a trigger based on the click text instead. We would then fire a tag whenever click text matches the value of add to cart. If you still can't find a way to identify the button you want to track, then I recommend working with your web developer to adjust the way buttons are added to your website. For example, if you don't have a click class, a click ID, or any other way to identify the button, then ask your web developer to add a class to the buttons you want to track. You will then be able to use it to configure your variables and triggers in Google Tag Manager. Okay, now let's head back to Google Tag Manager. Once you've identified how to track your button, you can remove the trigger. I recommend disabling any variables that you don't need. So let's select Variables. And then Configure for the built-in variables. Okay, so coming back to the two examples we looked at previously, which were the button for the email newsletter form and the Add to Cart button, we identified that we could use the classes for these buttons in Google Tag Manager. So we're going to disable the options we don't need, but we will leave Click Classes enabled. And don't forget that if you found a different way to identify your button, then you'll need to enable the appropriate variable. For example, if you want to use the Forms class, then you would enable Form Classes. Or if you wanted to use the Forms ID, then you would enable Form ID. Or if you identified a Link ID, you would enable Click ID. Now it's time to create our tag, which will send data to Google Analytics. Let's select Tags. We can see there is an existing Google Analytics 4 or GA4 configuration tag and a Universal Analytics tag. You'll need to make sure you already have a Google Analytics 4 configuration tag. If you don't, then I've included extra resources for you in the description below this video. Now, let's click New. We need to name our tag. I'm going to name the tag Google Analytics GA4 Button Email Newsletter. And let's select Tag Configuration and choose GA4 Event as the tag type. If you're not using Google Analytics 4, then you can apply the same techniques to any other tags you want to create in Google Tag Manager, including Universal Analytics tags. You'll just need to select a different type of tag. We need to select our existing GA4 configuration tag. And then we need to name our event. I'm going to name the event click_button. You can name your event anything you like. Now let's select Event Parameters. And let's add a row. Let's name the parameter button_class. And let's select the variable icon for the value. Let's select Click Classes as the variable. This will mean that the value of the class that we saw in the source code will be automatically sent to Google Analytics. You can send additional parameters with your events to Google Analytics 4, but I'm going to keep things simple for this example. Now it's time to add a trigger to our tag. Let's select Triggering. And now let's click the plus sign in the top right corner to create a new trigger for our tag. Let's name the trigger Button Email Newsletter. Now we select Trigger Configuration. And I'm going to select All Elements. Now we need to add a condition to the trigger so that it only fires when someone clicks the specific button we want to track. To do this, we're going to select Some Clicks. And then we're going to choose Click Classes from the drop-down. And then Contains. And enter the class we identified when we viewed the source code for our page. For my example, I'm going to enter newsletter-form-button. If you've found a different way to identify clicks on your button, then you'll need to select the appropriate variable for your condition. For example, if you're going to use the Forms class, then you would select Form Classes instead of Click Classes. Now we save the trigger. And we save the tag. Now let's create a tag for the Add to Cart button. Let's click New. And let's name the tag Google Analytics 4 GA4 Button Add. Let's select GA4 Event as the tag type. And let's select our GA4 configuration tag. Now let's name the event add_to_cart. And let's select event parameters and add a row. Let's name the parameter button_class. And let's select the variable icon for the value. Let's select the click classes variable again. Just like in the other tag we created, this will automatically pass the value of the class we saw in the source code. If you have any other details you'd like to send to Google Analytics as parameters, then you can add them. But again, I'm going to keep things simple for this example. Let's select Triggering. And let's click the plus sign in the top right corner to create a new trigger. Let's name the trigger Button Add to Cart. And let's select Trigger Configuration. And I'm going to select All Elements. And we need to add a condition to the trigger so that our tag only fires when someone clicks the Add to Cart button. So let's select Some Clicks. And choose Click Classes from the drop-down. And then Contains. Now we need to enter the class we identified for our Add to Cart button. For my example, I'm going to enter sqs-add-to-cart-button. Now we save the trigger. And the tag. Now it's time to preview the container and make sure we're correctly tracking our button clicks. To do this, let's click Preview. And head to our website. Now let's find our first button. And let's click it. Now let's find our second button. And click it. Now let's select the Tag Assistant tab. And we can select Click for the second button we clicked. We can see that our tag has fired. We can select the tag. And we can then see that our trigger successfully fired the tag. Let's close this. And let's select Click for the first button we clicked. Again, we can see that our tag has fired. And we can select the tag. We can see the trigger fired our tag and sent the event to Google Analytics. Once you've tested your buttons, you can head back to Google Tag Manager and publish your container to your live website. Let's summarize the steps we need to take to track button clicks using Google Tag Manager. You'll need to enable the built-in variable to identify when someone clicks your button. Then you'll need to create a tag to send the details to Google Analytics or any other platform. And finally, you'll need to create a trigger so that your tag only fires when the button you specify is clicked. I recommend testing your tag and trigger using Tag Assistant. To do this, click Preview in Google Tag Manager. What buttons are you going to track using Google Tag Manager? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below, and if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.